Welcome to yet another episode of Star Tales.
And guess who we have today? An enthusiastic entrepreneur whose professional life has always been with startups. The CTO of Urvin Labs, which is into an AI-driven workspace integrator for consulting and many such companies. It is none other than Ravi Dapati. Welcome. What a pleasure to have you with us today. How are you doing today?
I'm doing good, Rama. Thanks, thanks, Anil. How are you guys doing?
We're doing really good, Ravi. You see a lot of change, beard.
Yeah, I mean, just covering up my lockdown outputs. The hair belly.
Shifting back gears, Ravi, I have a very simple question for you. Would like to know your story and your professional journey. I'm sure it is very, very, very interesting. It's going to be a very jumpy ride, and I'm sure you find a pattern in the chaos that you have.
Right. So yeah, you know, I started my journey with Putney Computers in Pune, and that was around 18 years back. So I started with a career as a developer with some groupware technologies. And after that, I jumped into multiple companies like TCS, Nest Technologies, which were pretty established, process-oriented and all that. So, but that's not where my heart was, where I always wanted to be in a running mode rather than, you know, just sit down and watch the show kind of stuff. Then I jumped into a startup in Hyderabad, where we only had a table and chair. That's where it all started. So startup journey is always like, you see, it's a roller coaster. If you look at from a distance, it looks very colorful. It looks very adventurous. You wanted to jump into it and you really don't know how it would be until you get into that big wheel chase and all that, right? So one thing that I really love about the startup is there is nothing like it's not my job kind of stuff. So if you look into my career, basically I did everything. You know, I did L1, L2, L3 support. I did the design part of it. I did the development. I did the sales support. Except toilet cleaning, I did everything in the startup. I'm literally proud to say that. So that gives you a lot of confidence. You know, confidence is such a crazy thing which makes you vulnerable many a times. Once you are in startup, you cannot go into any other stream. You know, you have to be in startup world itself. That's how I started my journey with the startups, with one of the companies in Hyderabad. Then I moved to US, and even there I was part of a startup company. And we came back to India, and now I'm part of Urvin. Urvin is also a startup. I mean, as you rightly mentioned, we are into AI-enabled CRM, HR, and ATS space. We launched three different products in three different regions. India, Singapore, and US. And coming to my personal background, I'm from a very remote village in Andhra Pradesh. I did my schooling there. And after that, I did my engineering in electronics and communications. And after that, I did a couple of programs in Indian Institute of Sciences in Bangalore and also in IIM Bangalore in strategic management and project management streams. So, in short, yeah, that is what I am.
Wow, awesome.
Actually, IIC has been my dream organization. Glad to hear that you got an opportunity to be part of this organization. Now, you mentioned about startups, Ravi. Just a question, is it that you get attracted to the startups or the startups get attracted to you, or is it just a coincidence?
No. Basically, yeah, I wanted to be in a startup because that gives you a lot of exposure to many things to learn, right? You know, it is not something that someone can sit on your head and try things to get it done. It is something that whatever comes in your way, you can always experiment and execute it. And the kind of success you experience, you know, once you do these stuff, you know, from an ideation to delivery part, once you experience it, that success, you cannot come out of it, right? So It is my intention of going to startups after working for a very big corporate. So I was in roles of managing multi-million dollar projects and all that, where everything was established, the process, the teams, everything. You just go there and play your game. That's it. That is what you can do in established organizations. But particularly when it comes to the startup, right, you know, you can define your own game and you can play the game the way that you want it. The kind of success you get out of it is, infectious. You cannot actually come out of it. So I started, working in a startup, and after that, the journey continued, right? I never got a thought that, I spend good amount of time in startup. You know, this is the time that, I need to go to some established organizations and settle down kind of attitude. No, once you are in startup and you love working in startup, there is no way that you can come out of it.
Very true. Very true. Totally concur with you.
Awesome. Ravi, you are one of those leaders who totally believe in design. And I know you for the last 4 or 5 years. And let me ask you this. What are your thoughts on design and the role it plays in business problem solving today?
Right. World is getting complicated day by day, professionally, personally, wherever you go. There are a lot of complications. And if you look at the adoption of a digital, space, it has increased a lot in last 5 years, right? The time every individual is spending on digital device has incrementally increased like anything. In this complicated world, when you open any design, even that design itself is so complicated. The people are so much informed these days and they have too many options to choose, right? The moment they feel the complexity in the portals or the tools that they are using on day-to-day basis, it's just a matter of time that they can jump into the other one. So there is a lot of competition, a lot of easiness, from the user is expected these days. Design is extremely, extremely important. If you look back 5-6 years, down the line before, most of these enterprise-based applications, they used to design the business process and every business used to fit their way of working as per the tool, if you look at it. Now, it is completely changed. It is not the way that, the tools define and the organizations flow along. It is more of, user-defined, the business-defined, the product, the customer-defined. So if they don't find that easiness while using any portal, right, the options are extremely, extremely high these days. It's just a matter of a time. Even multi-billion organizations can be closed in a few months' time if that easiness is not there. So everything, if you look at, particularly in a product space, I've been in product space for almost 12, 13 years now. It has evolved quite a good number of changes in terms of the user behavior, the options that we are providing, the evolution of the design concepts. We are talking about human design concepts. We are talking about there is an evolution of different concepts that are coming up. So design is extremely, extremely important. It has to be consumer and customer driven rather than a feature driven, right? Particularly when we are talking about the enterprise-based applications, like if you take Urvin goes into multiple directions and we go in the extremely fast pace. So we are talking about CRM, we are talking about HR, we are talking about recruitment, we are talking about AI, we are talking about India location, Singapore location, USA location. We were into 100 directions and we go with infinity pace, right? So when you are doing that, there are chances that most of the things would pile up unless you don't have a proper structure in terms of the design concepts, the easiness for the user. At the end of the day, it would end up as a bunch of features but cannot be used by any user. Okay, so design concepts are extremely, extremely important. And my personal feel is it is not a standard thumb rule like you draw a line and you have to be on that line as such, right? It's a continuous evaluation process. Now, whatever concept that you put in yesterday, that might not work tomorrow, right? So that continuous learning has to be there, opening up your eyes and looking at how the consumer behavior is. Now, I have my Urvin product, which is designed for US users. Whatever concept that I'm putting for US might not work for Singapore. Right, I cannot actually put the same thing for Singapore customers because the design is also driven by the culture, right? You know, the color combinations, you know, the way the navigations work, the way that entire flow works. You know, it has to be a continuous evaluation process, but your concept has to be good. Your concept has to be solid. Based on that, it has to be, you know, evolved as per the region, the culture, the people, you know, the lot of factors that contributes to, you know, the design that we put in the product is what I feel strongly.
That was awesome. Design is such an iterative process. I have two questions. One, as the leader, you're so updated with design. And how do you ensure in an environment like Urwin, all the stakeholders believe in design? The entire team believes in design, because it's not just the CTO or a leader who totally believes in design. You need to bring that into the DNA of a startup, right? What are the things that you do internally so that people are aligned to it?
Oh, yeah. Okay. So, when your startup is in growing phase, as you build your teams, there are a lot of expectations that would come. You know, when you started, you know, it would be only one or two individuals who would be driving everything with one single decision. But when it comes to the design part of it, my belief is I never go with one option. Let's say, you know, this is what I wanted to implement, right? So the moment you go with one option, if it is not meeting the expectation of other people, it comes up with 3-4 options for each individual. Now that would be around 50 to 20 options where we cannot choose. My way of thing is I go with 3 or 4 options, right? So instead of actually trying to coin their own options, they're looking at one individual option that I provide. They would try to choose the best option out of 3. And I'll make sure whatever is the best option, I'll fine tune that so that, you know, all their concentration, everything will go there. That was one of the things which was really working out from quite some time. Yes, you know, as the organization grows, it is extremely important that you open up that space to everyone and all the ideas. It is not about one single individual. So recently, you know, from last few months, we started doing a lot of analysis on how the user behavior would be. We are taking up some set of surveys from the internal team and external team, existing customers, prospective customers, and we are collating it and we are understanding the behavior, how they wanted the whole system. And then we are coming up with the final solution. And that is not it right now. This is a mix. It is a mix of everyone's opinion as such. It is, you know, again, it's a evolving process. Once we move that to the production, we try to get the feedback from the customers where exactly their pain areas is. And when once we get all that feedback, we go back and do that, you know, final polishing to what we have done, you know, until it reaches to a stage that, you know, this is what we wanted as a final output to the product.
Great. Ravi, how do you keep yourself updated? You know everything about design, you know what's happening in the tech world, you're so aligned with the business, and you also contribute all this back to the industry. Your articles are amazing on LinkedIn, be it you align business growth with Chanakya's Neeti or whatever it is. How do you keep yourself updated? Like you spoke about design is not just a look and feel. It's about a solution. You study about the culture, you study about the geography, and you align your colors and aesthetics to it. Where do you get all this knowledge from? How do you keep yourself updated?
I mean, if you are not learning every day in this competitive world, it's just like standing and watching the world while the whole world is racing like anything. You know, at the end of the day, whatever you have, you would end up as a loser, right? So yeah, we work very hard, you know, in the startup. You know, typically we used to work almost 18 to 20 hours a day, literally. But one day in a week is completely dedicated for myself. You know, either it would be a half day or full day. That day I don't dedicate, you know, any time to anyone, not even to my wife, right? So that is the day, either it is a 5 hours continuously or 4 hours continuously, you read the articles, you try to find out what is really happening around the world, spend some time on, you know, any technical things that you wanted to learn. That really helps basically, you know, not only in terms of learning, but your confidence level. When you are talking about any particular topic, even if you have some basic understanding of what it is really, you know, that gives you a lot of confidence in terms of solutioning as well. Let's say if I wanted to solution something in a product, you need to have some idea about all aspects of it. the design aspect of it, the business domain aspect of it, the technical aspect of it, the customer behavioral aspect of it. Once you have all this information handy to you, it is extremely, you know, easy for you to, you know, build an innovative solution for any of these real-time problems, you know. So that is what I have been doing for last 8-9 years, you know. Dedicate one day, right? Either, it is not necessarily that you need to read books, you need to sit in front of the laptop. You sleep that whole day. One thing that is lacking in the guys who work for startup is a peaceful sleep. If you have a peaceful sleep for one full day, you would be charged up for the next 6 days, right?
That's the takeaway. I have one last question for you, Ravi. You're so random. Sometimes I call you, you're in Rishikesh. Sometimes you're doing a random road trip. Like, is that your way of taking a break from whatever you're doing, or what is it?
Yes. I mean, it is extremely important that you enjoy what you do, right? It is not always the destination, but it is the journey that matters, right? So when we are in startup, we were literally into everything. As I was mentioning, you would be in the design, development, sales, support, demos, BA, data science, mobile, you name it, you are every day. So your body and mind says you, you know, it gives you a warning that, okay, you are overbumped. This is the time that you need to take a break, right? So if your body and mind gives you that gesture, you shut down everything and you need to charge yourself, you know? So everyone will have their own way of charging themselves. So mine is backpack and just go wherever you feel like. So that is how I typically do. I do the backpacking. I don't plan any tours as such, you know. I go to railway station and then I decide where I need to go, and I'll take a ticket and go. That gives you the local flavor, right? You know, when you are going to a remote village and if you are going by taxi, you don't understand what it is. You know, everything you see out of the window is what you feel it would be. But once you are walking and interacting with the people and living with them, then you understand. That actually gives you, lot of exposure in terms of what are the different kinds and varieties of people we have, their culture. And that would definitely reflect in the way that you manage people. You manage your organization. You manage your product, right? So that is extremely important. I would encourage everyone to definitely take a break, you know, go wherever you want, not like, you know, without informing your wife and all that, but, you know, go with a proper plan, unless you have that. Yes, you know, I have that passion of just backpacking and leave.
Awesome.
Yeah, that was so insightful, Ravi. Thank you so much. Such candid and down-to-earth answers. I'm sure you are inspiration to a lot of people, both in your professional life and also in personal life, because I see non-professional, non-materialistic aspect to everything that you take it up. Pretty impressive. So thank you so much for your time and all your insights.
Thanks, Rama. Thanks, Anil. Thank you for your time. Thanks for the opportunity.
Thank you so much, Ravi. Thank you. Thanks for your time. And all the best with Urban. And it's one of those products which has taken a design-first approach. And I can see this product reaching millions of people and enabling and empowering businesses through your offerings. Thank you so
thanks,
much.
Thanks, Anil. Thank you very much. Thanks for your time.
Thank you so much. I hope all of you enjoyed listening to this particular session. Stay tuned for more.